agency which helps with the user fund and distribution, USASA, as well as the representative of the government of the Northern Cape and Gauteng. We're here to showcase some of the work we're doing in the ICT sector in South Africa and to highlight a small sample of some of the innovation in our country. We have also been joined by the following small medium enterprises. First one is Lobster Consulting Solution, Kimberley in the Northern Cape. The company specializes in the web services development and recently designed and introduced an innovation called Rent a Posi or Rent My Home accommodation to solve the accommodation problems of many students around Kimberley area. The second one is Page Communication from Durban in KwaZulu-Natal, which specializes in value-added smartphones. The company has designed and developed premium smartphones, working together with international partners, and it intends going in full commercial operations in the near future, of course, with the support of our government. The third one is the SASI ICT from Postmasberg in the Northern Cape, which specializes in software development and currently focuses on development of online government services for the Department of Economic Development and Tourism. The fourth one is Simplus Innovation from Johannesburg in Gauteng, which specializes in on the Internet of Things technologies and big data analytics in the mining and telecommunication industry. The company currently provides solutions to Altec Nesta, among others. And the fifth one is Labs Innovation from Pretoria, Gauteng. The company operates from the Innovation Hub in Johannesburg, one of our innovation centers experience and specializes in software development, prototype development, and related innovation solutions. Companies currently provide services to Royal Bafokeng Platinum. These companies were selected by our Department of Telecommunications and Postal Services, working together with the Department of Small Business Development and Small Enterprise Development Agency. Their presence and participation is in line with the department's effort to create an enabling environment to unlock the innovative capacity among our youth in the ICT sector. We are particularly keen to work with the SMEs that respond to South Africa's social and economic realities and needs. The government has been working with the industry on ways to create opportunities for the SMEs to participate in innovation. This includes the establishment of the Innovation Hub, such as the University of Witwatersrand in collaboration with IBM. This hub allows digital innovators to create solutions and help to solve South Africa problem under incubation. In addition, last year the department signed a cooperation agreement with Huawei to launch a Huawei Innovation and Experience Center in South Africa. This allows SMEs to gain opportunities to share their ideas in a space like gaming, video and app development, where they can test and advance their solutions and gain exposure to partnership opportunities. Our research institute, CSIR, who's with us here, used this opportunity to showcase the digital innovation related to fourth industrial revolution, such as 5G, media streaming, cybersecurity, Internet of Things, and spectrum management. To provide a holistic ecosystem to support innovation and promote economic growth, the department will submit and we are finalizing our SMME development strategy, which will soon be submitted to our cabinet for approval. We support the international focus of SMME as a driver for development by the ITU and other international organizations. This is key to building a resilient digital future and to provide opportunities for some of the SMEs to engage their counterparts and forge partnerships internationally in pursuit of their business models and plans. Three SMEs from South Africa, namely Cintas Innovation, Labs Innovations, and the Tasi ICT, have been shortlisted for the ITU Global SME Awards, and we are praying and wishing that they pitch quite cut good enough that they'd be one of the finalists in terms of winning. Yesterday, these SMEs had an opportunity to present their innovation to a panel of adjudicators. Announcement of the final winners will be made on Thursday at the conclusion of the ITU Telecom World 2017. We wish our SME well in these highly competitive awards. South Africa has a unique e-skills model that was endorsed by the ITU in 2012 as one of the best. Our approach is to build human capacity through collaboration with key stakeholders, aim at providing new skills and competencies for our digital future, including high-level innovation and new accredited course for e-students. This program is undertaken with South African universities, which benefit from a dedicated high-speed broadband network that is evidenced by academic world. Since our arrival, we have participated in the following activities at the ITU Telecom World. First, the World Economic Forum Internet for All session. South Africa and WEF launched an Internet for All partnership program that we launched in Durban in May this year on the sidelines of the World Economic Forum Africa. Since then, a significant number of companies in the private sector have committed to work with the government and the state-owned companies to speed up the drive to connect the unconnected. In particular, most of the companies have committed to participate in the e-literacy and other skills development initiative as we seek to skill our nation. Secondly, at the opening ceremony where South Africa was one of the keynote speakers. Thirdly, the minister was one of the panelists in one of the leadership summit sessions focusing on building a resilient digital future. Later today, we will participate in the ministerial roundtable on digitized citizen first, which will allow us to reflect on the efforts to connect the 22 million South Africans that are connected to the internet. In conclusion, South Africa has indicated its willingness to consider hosting 2018 ITU Telecom World event, and in consultations with the ITU are ongoing. We expect the final decision to be made in the coming days. We have informed our key stakeholders back at home about this exciting development, and we are working with them, and indications are that there is widespread support for this opportunity back at home. Industry players also indicated their willingness to work with us should this opportunity be granted by the ITU. The hosting of the ITU World Telecom 2018 will provide an opportunity for Africa as a whole to showcase the continent's capabilities and will provide opportunities for further innovation and investment. There are a lot of investment opportunities in Africa. We believe that Africa has what it takes to host this event of this magnitude. The hosting of this event will take place around the same time we will be hosting the BRICS ICT ministers meeting, which will also be hosted by South Africa. The two events combined will place our country and the continent on the smart digital map as an important player in our collective digital future. It will also enable South Africa to engage with a range of key and influential stakeholders. As we prepare for the International Telecommunications Year, maybe potentially conference in the United Arab Emirates, which is the highest decision making body in the telecommunication, on the telecommunication plan. We are also hoping for the support to be given an opportunity to serve on the ITU Executive Council. South Africa is pleased with the proceedings of the 2017 event and believes that multilateral platforms like the International Telecommunication Union and its events allow countries to share ideas on some of the topical issues of the day, including the next wave of the fourth industrial revolution and new production revolution. Engagement amongst countries in an inclusive manner, including with developing countries, will ensure that all of us can leverage the opportunities of the fourth industrial revolution. For us, all these issues are underpinned by our plan to create a thriving, inclusive digital society. I thank you.